from WWL-TV. The Spirit of Louisiana. This is Louisiana's news leader, Channel 4's Eyewitness News Night Watch.
Good evening. I'm Dennis Woltering in for Mike Haas.
And I'm Lucy Bustamante. It is a move that's designed to protect the levee along the 17th Street Canal.
But some homeowners are now questioning whether the benefits are really there and whether they legally should have to give up part of their property for the cause. Begad Shaban has the story.
For the last month, Julie Thrasher has lived right on the 17th Street Canal. But the space between her home and the levee just got a little wider. Her landlord recently scaled back the property line.
He was told that he was going to have to move the property fence line back 6 feet.
Thrasher says those orders came from the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Acting on behalf of the state's East Bank Levee Authority and the Orleans Levee District, the Corps is planning to remove trees, fences, and other property resting between the levee and the 6 feet mark past the levee toe, which is where the land begins to flatten out.
In a high wind event, a tree could topple, it could open up a flow path and increase the risk to public safety of water moving through the levee.
The Corps says legally they can do with the property what they feel necessary.
By state ordinance, the levee authorities have that right of entry in order to ensure we maintain stability function of the levee for public safety.
Attorney Randall Smith disagrees.
Well, the state statute they're referring to affects navigable waterways. The 17th Street Canal is not a navigable waterway.
Today, Smith filed a lawsuit on behalf of 15 homeowners. They're suing the Orleans Levee District and the state's East Bank Levee Authority, hoping to get a restraining order to stop the Corps from touching anyone's property.
If this is the best thing for New Orleans, fine. But do it, follow the proper procedure, do it the right way, and compensate people. Don't just say you're just going to enter their land and tear down their things.
Smith says under the Corps plan, homeowners would not be compensated for their land. And he questions if it's even in the best interest of the people of New Orleans to take on the project during hurricane season. Still, the Corps contends it would only take up to 4 weeks. And they say clearing out the property is crucial.
Well, this is paramount to ensuring the safety of the people in the New Orleans area that's impacted.
Now, according to the Corps, 40 homeowners would be affected by the move, but Attorney Randall Smith says it's more like 70. If the Corps has to remove any fencing, homeowners will be the ones stuck with the bill to put that fencing back up farther away from the levee. That is, unless there's a pool in the backyard, then the Corps says they'll pay for a temporary fence. Now, the work is expected to start this Monday, but tomorrow at 10 a.m., those on both sides of the issue will meet before a judge to hear, Dennis and Lucy, whether or not a temporary restraining order will actually be granted.
All right, Begad, thank you.